Come and get it, come and get it.
Long before cooking became competitive, he was the face of Australian cuisine.
He's Australia's brightest spark.
Best known for his tasty five-minute show on the ABC, Come and Get It, ran for 9 years and permanently cemented his catchphrase into the Australian psyche. Since then, he's gone on to cook for royalty, written and illustrated books. He's even a cartoonist. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please say good day to Peter Russell-Clarke.
Peter Russell-Clarke is here. Welcome to Studio 10.
Thank you.
You feel like the Aussie legend that you've been coined as? You got a bit embarrassed watching that back.
I remember many years ago a young lad saying to me, how do you cook? And I said, well, if you put a chicken in the oven and in 20 minutes it's white, you forgot to turn the oven on. If it's black, you've turned the gas too high. If it's brown, you've done well.
Oh. Well, you've taught us lots of things over the years. What are you going to cook for us today?
I'm buggered if I know.
Oh, I think it's your famous fig and mango omelette, isn't it?
Well, it is. I'm glad that you've recognised that. And so I do. I start cooking now?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So we've been pitching this as a breakfast product all morning, but it's actually a bit of an entree, isn't it? Or maybe a fancy brekkie product?
I don't think that we should put labels on food. Okay. I think that if you want a lot of food, then you cook a lot of food. If you want a little bit of food, you cook a little bit of food.
Okay.
So it's oil.
Oil.
Oil, here it is.
Oh.
And is this just your stock standard olive oil?
Olive oil. The idea is to make sure that the eggs that we're going to cook don't stick to the pan.
Mm-hmm.
And so one of the things I think when people cook omelettes, they... Excuse me, Ida.
Yeah.
They actually put the eggs into a bowl and mix them up. And I've never understood why.
It's straight in the pan.
Why can't you just do that?
Oh, wow.
And you also say two eggs rather than three eggs because you think three eggs is too many.
Well, it is for that pan. If I had a big pan, I'd put 8 eggs in it.
Oh, right.
If I had a bigger pan, I'd put 15 eggs in it. If I had a much smaller pan, I'd only put 1 egg in it.
I got you.
Good. Now, since we're not making scrambled eggs, if we're doing scrambled eggs, we'd keep moving that around. Since we're not, we're doing an omelette, I'm just going to leave it. And I can put any flavours I like in that. That's a little bit of ginger.
Ooh.
The reason I'm putting ginger in is because I want it to taste a bit like ginger. I'm not putting salt in it because salt toughens protein.
Oh,
does it?
Yes. If you spill your red wine on the carpet, which is sacrilege, not for the carpet but for the fact you're wasting red wine, you put salt on the carpet and that draws the red wine
out. It does
too. It does, right. Well, salt does the same with food. If you put salt in that, it'll draw all the protein and minerals out of the food. And it also toughens the protein. So you don't put that in, the salt in, until the last minute. That's if you need it. I don't think you need it.
When Jono drops his red wine on the carpet, he grabs a straw.
Mm.
So what's next? So the eggs are going well. So do we need to cut anything up here? Can we be helpful in the kitchen?
No, you can't be.
Oh.
The reason you can't be is because you've obviously not been helpful before, I can see. And so those eggs are cooking. That's a bit of mango. The reason I'm using mango is because I've got mango here. If we had tomatoes, I'd be using tomatoes.
But this is called fig and mango omelette.
That's the reason we're using the mangoes.
That's right. Okay.
And a little bit of fig. If you want a fruit salad, you'd use a lot of mango and a lot of fig, but we don't.
Mm.
We don't want fruit salad. So that's really just for the visual. The colour of it's good. The taste is practically negligible. The reason I keep taking that off is I don't want that to overcook.
Right.
Do you add cheese?
No.
No cheese.
Do you know why?
No, tell me.
We haven't got any cheese.
Yes, but we could get some cheese.
Jono used them all on his jokes. So this is part of a brand new cookbook that you have coming out, the Great Australian Cookbook.
Well,
why did you choose?
I don't have it coming out. Some very good people have it coming out.
Apologies, yes,
and
there it is.
I'm not the only wanker in it. There's many, many others.
Well, there's a very distinguished cast of cooks in there. There's Maggie Beer and there's Neil Perry, I think.
And Margaret Fulton.
Oh, Margaret Fulton, isn't she wonderful?
She is. I actually like Margaret Fulton.
Me too.
Yeah, she's good. But there's chefs that know everything and chefs that know nothing. I come with the later. I know lots of things, like that you're a good person. You're looking younger.
Oh, I love you too. Oh. You can all go away. Is this on the cook?
We'll leave you
reason,
the eggs.
The reason I've put that on the side of the pan away from the handle is because when we turn that over, if that was that side, doesn't matter. It's all too hard.
It would fall out.
That's right. Mm.
Okay, it smells good.
And just a bit of greenery.
So this is just a bit of chives.
And
shallots.
That's it.
Well,
see
that's
that?
Pretty simple, isn't it?
That is simple. Well, we're all... Well, I wouldn't go that far. I wouldn't have gone that far, actually.
Well, I don't mean simple,
but... cutlery to give you a taste, unless you wanted to use this item.
It's very good for television because you don't have to worry too much about it, you see.
No, I'll just use my fingers. Delicious.
She would say that.
I wouldn't expect anything less.
Now, you can get this recipe and many more in the Great Australian Cookbook, which is out now. Peter, come back and see us again. It'll come back and see Ida at least.
Yeah. Thank you. Good to see you.
You too.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure.